مرحبا، أنا اسمي سوزان بريمو.
مرحبا، اسمي لما راعي.
مرحبا، أنا اسمي جورج بشارة.
مرحبا، أنا اسمي ريتا دلال وأريد أصير دكتورة.
وأنا عم بدرس لحتى أصير جراحة.
بالمستقبل أنا حابة أصير دكتورة
وعم أدرس طب بشري.
طب العلم من المهد إلى اللحد.
عاشر الناجحين والمكافحين، فالنجاح معدي.
التعليم هو أقوى سلاح يمكنك استخدامه لتغيير العالم.
قد تكون البدايات صعبة، ولكن الاستمرار هو مفتاح النجاح.
My name is Yumna El-Said. I am a Syrian refugee. I was born and raised in Damascus, Syria. Due to the war in 2011, I had to unfortunately leave my country and move to a different place.
The reason that we left Syria and we went to Turkey because civil war started and we started getting a lot of bombs going on in our area. My family felt it wasn't safe to stay. We even ran out of food because everything was shut down.
In 2011, the Syrian civil war first started. During that time, my family was searching for a way out. We traveled down to Saudi Arabia during that time. We lived there for a few years before we finally got our immigration visas in 2016.
We came here in 2010. I was 8 years old. So we were refugees of war. We moved to Jordan for 3 years, and then we came here, and I have spent most of my life in the US.
We had our interviews and everything done in a year. And then we came to the US in 2016.
I lived in Jordan for 5 years. Then we were very blessed that my family was selected to immigrate to the US.
One day my dad got a call from the UN and they asked my dad if he wanted to sign up to travel outside of Turkey and find a new home. And we heard that we're going to be able to come to the US. We were very excited.
You know, we heard the news that we're going to be traveling to the US. It felt like a dream come true. We would never really imagined having the ability to come here.
When I heard we are moving to the United States, it was kind of hard for me because I was thinking I have to start a new culture, a new language to learn, and I had to start basically from zero.
It was a bit hard since I am in a new country where I don't know the language, I don't know anyone.
I think there are a lot of barriers to coming here, and not just with, you know, the language and the culture, but also like the shock you get when you come to a new place. The safety, like the whole difference of there being a third world country and then coming here. My mom always said like she can actually go to sleep without worrying if she's gonna be up the next day, which doesn't happen very often back home.
I think for me, family has been really everything. Since the day we moved out of Syria, it was kind of us against the world everywhere we almost went.
My parents have been supporting me and my siblings all the way since high school until now college and future education.
They left their entire family, their parents and their sisters and brothers to find a better future for us.
It's a big toll on them for sure. And it's something that until this day I continue to appreciate and look up to the immense sacrifice that they've provided to us.
I knew what I wanted since I was a kid. I knew I wanted to be helping people using science. So education was the first step. If I can use science in my love and passion for education to help others, why not?
One door that education has opened to me is mentoring refugees in their early years, so their first or second year in the US.
Mentorship has been something that's been very, very fulfilling and enjoyable for me to do. It's just so easy to feel lost and hopeless and feel like you don't know what the next step is.
So as a mentor, we help Syrian refugees who just resettled to the US the same way we did.
I've been mentoring two Syrian girls and it's been very rewarding and nice because you've seen the passion that you had once in their eyes.
Now that we're working with Syrian students, they feel very connected to us because we were just like them.
Just being able to touch into like small parts of their lives can really put a big impact.
We saw a need within the population that there's a lot of gaps within the healthcare system that these individuals fall through those gaps. And we decided to open the REACT clinic that's currently running. REACT is an acronym for the Refugee Education and Clinic Team. It's an ASU Mayo Clinic collaboration with the goal to provide health education for refugees and asylum seekers here in Arizona.
It's a student-run free clinic with the ASU students as volunteers and then the Mayo Clinic medical students.
We will go to communities and give them a presentation.
We offer them transportation services, language services. We provide free healthcare to those patients, healthcare screenings. We're slowly transitioning now to becoming a primary care clinic.
That's really why I want to do what I want to do, connecting patients with things, taking away any barriers they have to care.
Sometimes it's very, very difficult to take things a step further without education. Education is that connect between curiosity and making something a reality.
Through education, I have got to make amazing friends. I have got to meet a lot of people and leave a big impact.
Education has opened the door for me to have more opportunities and more jobs that I can apply to.
I think you really have to want something to get it.
Working hard is very important to you in order to be successful.
I try to, you know, put myself out there, do any opportunity I can just to learn more about it. So I think it has to come from within you.
If you are not being uncomfortable doing what you're doing, that means you're not on the right path.
STEM is a field full of curiosity, full of exploration, and it's for those who are looking to pursue a field that is continuously evolving, that's full of energy, full of collaborations.
The STEM field is not just becoming a doctor or becoming an engineer or becoming a physician or something like this. It's very wide, it's very open. Even in biology, chemistry, or anything else, it's just the future.
Every day there is something new happening. Especially here, we are in a country where there's a lot of things happening so fast when it comes to science.
It's that interconnectedness that allows these fields to be brought a step further, to be evolved and to become better.
You will get to learn a lot of things that will literally amaze you every day.
I'm very proud to be a Syrian because my culture is full of resilient people and full of inspirational people.
It's okay to struggle. You'll get through it and you'll end up being in a place that you never imagined you would be.
I would reach out to mentors and people who would be willing to give you their advice.
Never give up. Just do what you're doing right now and keep working on it. At the end, I'm 100% sure you're gonna see the result of it and you're gonna be so proud of yourself.
In Arabic, we say tikkil 'ala Allah, which means rely on God. To me, religion is a big thing in my life, and relying on God has been the biggest thing that has helped me find hope.
And my dad always said, take the good from both cultures and leave the bad. That's what they've always preached to me.
Really get out of your comfort zone. I know it's hard, I've been there. If you're gonna be always comfortable, it means there is something wrong. In order to be successful, you have to go out there.
مشوار الألف مايل بيبدأ بخطوة. The road of 1,000 miles starts with one step. I know it's not an easy journey, but it always starts with one step.